I have moved again. This is a new planet. This planet has water. And that's exactly the reason I moved, because what happened? That's the exact reason I moved, because of the water here. So it's a little weird how they planted this base right here, and I had to set things down next to a mountain. But that's okay, because when you set buildings down, it automatically carves the mountain out. I put a round building in here just so I could put this round building in here, but I replaced it with the squares. I put this in here because there are other things that I wanted to plant. And then here are some squares on the side. And I had to put these, what do you call it? Let me look. Let's see. There you go. Foundation. I had to put these foundations in here just so that I could, I mean, just to make it look, you know, normal. Here it is, foundation. Okay. So I put these foundations in here just to make it look like it's not going to fall. Although this one's missing a leg. I don't know. Anyway, two legs. This one's missing two legs. That's okay. It doesn't matter. I had to build this up because I don't know if I used the right material, but I had to build it up because I couldn't add another one of these ramps. All I could do was jump up. So it's basically the same as before. It's just got another round building back here. Everything is basically the same as before, except for the back doesn't have the square glass rooms like all the way across, and there are no containers because all the containers are on the freighter. But otherwise, all these rooms are the same, with the cactus in these two rooms and the mushrooms in the other three rooms. Or biodomes, excuse me. And then I have this out here. You know, let me get to my ship. Oh, and then this planet also has boiling monsoons, but I'm not going to find any better. The only thing that sets this planet apart from my previous planet is that this planet actually has water. So I'm just gonna jump up to the ship, our freighter. And this is the last place that I jumped, I warped to with my freighter. And I thought I better go look at the planets and see if there are any good planets that I could, create a new base in. And this time I was smart and I removed everything and stored them in the freighter storage units. I bought this ship because it has a whole bunch of storage. I bought this ship just because. And then the ship that I just flew in right there, just because I wanted to have something different. Something small. And where's my regular ship? My regular ship is probably in the back. on this side. Yep, it's all the way in the back. Okay, so I did make some changes in my freighter in this room back here. I took out that second floor since the floor seems to disappear every time I warp. And this room will not stay red. So, all the second floor is gone. It's just got my containers and these four. I put these two guys together. I couldn't put my other Viking in here because he will only be a base guy due to the fact that his purpose is the exocraft. So, and here's my zero. Then this room and the room across there are just planters for carbon, so that whenever I need to make warp cells, I could just take them from this thing, these things. I start with the carbon to make the suspension fluid, and I go to the electron vapor and antimatter and warp fluid, or I mean warp cell. And these are carat sheets are all left over from the glass rooms, so I can sell those since I no longer need them. And that's about it. That's everything that's different from the last time. And I have warped, I think it was like 63,000 light years or something, 63 or 65,000 light years. Since I've had this freighter, I think. You know, ever since I bought this, I waited. This game was originally $60, and I waited until it was $23. And for such a long time, I heard all these horrible things about this game, but it's really fun. You know, they said it was supposed to be a multiplayer game, but it's pretty much a single player game. I haven't been able to play with anybody, but you know, I seem to have fun on my own, and it's a bit addicting to me. And you know what? I'm more than happy to play it on my own. If they eventually decide to let players play together, great. Nobody wants to play with me anyway, so it doesn't really matter. But anyway. So those are the different changes that I've made to my base, planet, freighter. Everything's different. So I'm going to take this one down to the... Oh, and I named it Away Shuttle. I can see the floor in this one for some reason, which makes it kind of hard to fly, but that's only from when I leave the bay, freighter, I can see the floor. When I leave from the planet, I don't see the floor at all. That's kind of weird. Seems to be frozen. It does that every time. There we go. And it seems to have, like, crashed me. What the heck? It seems like I've crashed into the side of the building. The heck? At least it didn't push me down underneath the ground. Oh my goodness, I just, like, wrecked it. I wrecked it! Call Geico. I need AAA over here fast. Okay. Oop, can't get in. Oh yeah. One of the things that I found when I was trying to, on my other planet, since there was no water in sight, whenever I wanted to upgrade my exosuit, I would use the one with the wheels, but since I'm on a planet with water, if I want to upgrade my exosuit, all I have to do is go like this, and it searches for drop pods. I go to the drop pod, which may take a few minutes. Like in this case, only 3 minutes. Once I get there, then I search for another drop pod, and I continue from there. I go from drop pod this way, and excuse me. I seem to be able to get the drop pods a lot faster since I have the ability to search for them on my vehicle. The old way, I'd have to look for a beam of light and go down and use one of the beacons that was already on the planet. I think it's better to just, you know, use the exo vehicle to do that. Oh, and the animals on this planet look like little T-Rex dinosaurs, and it's so funny, if I ride near them too close, they will literally die. They'll fall over and die. And they're all vicious. They all want to attack me. And as soon as one tries to attack me, just getting near me, it ends up dying without even hurting me. It just dies. I don't want them to die, but it's just the way it happens in this game. And they're so adorable. Oh no, this isn't the one that looks like. There's ones that look like T-Rexes. This is not one of them. See if I can find one. Oh, I think I just killed one. Yeah, I just killed one. Poor thing, I'm sorry. That one looks like he's limping. Sorry, guys. There's a drop pod. Let's see, I go to this thing first. Save and chart. Now I've got 43 slots. Or maybe there's 42. I don't know. I've got 13 slots here, and I've maxed this one out. I can't add any more. So I think I'll add one here. The higher ones, yeah, 42 slots. The higher ones hold about 500 like frost crystals or plutonium or whatever, or like Karai sheets. There's five glass. The regular ones only hold about 250. So I like to upgrade the high capacity inventory slots. But I've been updating these just because, let me if I can make craft before I die. Okay, I'm gonna go back home, or to the base. So I'm going to call my ship. I think I have to be out of this car first. There we go. There we go. Nope, just oh splat. Okay. So once I get to the base, then I can summon my exocraft. I find it easier to just, you know, upgrade all my exosuit slots with the exocraft, because it gets me there faster. And then when I'm done, after I've, you know, collected, or not collected, but upgraded them as much as I want to, then I just, you know, summon the ship just to get back faster. And it freezes during a boiling monsoon storm. And when the storm is over, I'll summon that vehicle. But for now, I'm just going to go, and I want to thank you for watching, and I hope you have a wonderful day.